Hello students, welcome back to my YouTube channel John Lewis 3D Learning. In this presentation we are going to see language of chemistry in 9th standard, elements, symbols based on IUPAC system. So it is there in all types of boards, ICSE, CBSE and all Indian state boards. Medium is English. So first of all, what is a symbol? A symbol is a short form that stands for the atom of a specific element. So we have seen lots of symbols based on Berzelius system in the last video. H for hydrogen, O for oxygen, like that. That is what it is, a short form that stands for the atom of a specific element. That's it. Oh, it can be defined in another way also. That also we have seen in the last video. A symbol is the abbreviation used for the name of the element. Okay, so now let's go and see in detail. So symbols of elements were developed in three stages. First of all, John Dalton developed a system, a pictorial diagram. In the form of pictorial diagram, he gave symbols for all the elements. But that was obscure and it was difficult to learn and remember and apply. Therefore, John's Jacob Berzelius, he developed a new system. So that's what we learnt in the last video. So in the first part we have seen John Dalton. In the second part we had seen John's Jacob Berzelius system. And today what we are going to see is the final system, that is IUPAC system. So these are the two scientists, no? John Dalton and John's Jacob Berzelius. They developed shorthand symbols for all the elements. So when John Dalton started, there were around 20 elements. But when Jacob Berzelius, when he gave symbol for all the elements, there were hardly 30 elements. But today there are 118 elements. But they paved way, or they created a system for the following scientists to think on this line, so that a systematic method can be developed and applied in giving symbols for all the elements. So that is what is known as IUPAC system. So today we are going to learn IUPAC system, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. So this is a governing body for the entire world. So now, what is the first rule? The symbols of most elements, mainly non-metals, use the first letter of their English name. Hydrogen, what is the first letter? H. Oxygen, what is the first letter? O, like that. So here some examples: hydrogen, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, phosphorus, sulfur, iodine. See, in the last presentation itself we have seen Berzelius system, 11 elements at one letter symbol, all those things we have seen. So it's a repetition here. Okay, what is the second method? What is the second rule, in fact? If the name of the element has the same initial letter as another element, then the symbol uses the first and second letters of their English name. See, first letter is same for two metals. Then how can we do that? See, for example, you have to take two letters, first letter and the second letter. For example, hydrogen, we have given the symbol H. For helium also it is starting with H. Therefore, what we need to do? So hydrogen already we have assigned with hydrogen. Therefore, the second letter is also taken. Helium, H-E. Lithium, L-I. Beryllium, B-E. Neon, N-E. Because N is given to nitrogen already. Aluminium, A-L. Okay, there is no symbol as A for any element. Why? Because in English, A is used as a one letter word. It is one of the articles, am I right? A and the. So A is very frequently used in English language. Therefore, that is not given as a symbol for any element. So therefore, as far as those elements starting with letter A, no element is having just the symbol A. All the elements are having two letters only. Okay. Now, what is the third rule? if the first two letters of the element name are the same as another element, see, if the first letter is same, we have taken the second letter. Okay, fine. If the second letter is also same, what we can do? And that is what? See, if the second letter is also same, what we need to do is, we need to take the first consonant in the name of the element after the second letter, that we have to take it. For example, here you take some example here, magnesium and manganese. So you take magnesium, MAGNESIUM, then manganese, MANGANESE. So M first letter is same, then second letter you take AA, second letter is same. Therefore, what we can do after that, what is the first consonant, not vowel, what is the first consonant? So in magnesium, G is a consonant, I mean, right after A. Therefore, MG is taken for magnesium. In manganese, M, that A is same, therefore we have left it. And what is the next consonant? N. N is a consonant, it is not a vowel. Therefore, manganese is given MN symbol. Have you understood this? If the second letter is same, what we need to do? We need to take the first consonant after the second letter. Okay, so let us take one more example here. For example, you take chlorine, CHLORINE, and you take chromium, CHROMIUM. So first letter is C, therefore we take for both C, and second letter is HH for both of them, therefore we omitted. Okay, what is the next consonant? So in chlorine, L is a consonant, therefore chlorine is assigned the symbol CL. In chromium, after H it is R. R is also a consonant, it is not a vowel. Therefore, chromium is given the symbol CR. Students, hope you understood it very clearly. See, we need not rote memorize everything. Try to understand the logical reason behind them, and it becomes very easy to remember, and it will be very interesting to learn also. Okay, so shall we move on to the next one? Some symbols are based on the old name or Latin name of the element. So we have seen in the last presentation itself, there were 11 elements, symbols were based on their Latin name, and one of them is German name, that is tungsten, wolfram. So W is taken from the first letter of the word wolfram, which is a German word. All other words are Latin words. So some example here, just a quick revision, we have already learnt in the last presentation. So sodium, Na, it is derived from Latin name natrium, first two letter Na. Kalium, first letter K. Then iron is ferrum, therefore the first two letter Fe. Then copper, cuprum, first two letter Cu. Argentum, that is silver, is argentum, that is silver, Latin name is argentum, therefore the first letter is not, first two letters are not taken here. Why? Because argon have been discovered before silver. So that argon was given the symbol AR. So silver was discovered after that. Therefore that R is left here and AG is taken for silver. Then tin, stannum, SN. Then stibium, SB. Then tungsten, wolfram, W. And then gold, aurum, AU. And then mercury, hydrargyrum. HY, that is not V, hydrargyrum, HG, and lead is plumbum, PB. Okay, if you like to learn in detail, go and watch part 2 of this lesson. So this is part 3 of this lesson. You go to the previous video, watch it again, so that you can understand this very clearly. I have dealt this in detail there. Okay, shall we move on to the next one? Okay, new elements are those with disputed claims for discovery, synthesis, are named using three letters based on Latin for their atomic numbers. See, now 118 elements have been discovered, and those elements beyond atomic number 100 are given three letter symbols. Temporarily they were given three letter symbols. So that is based on what? First letter is uni or un. Uni or un means what? One in Latin. The second letter N stands for nil, zero. And third letter from Latin numerical prefix, one is mono, 2 is di, 3 is tri, and 4 is q for quadrangle, am I right? So q for 4, penta, p, then h for hex, hexa, 6, then s for septa, septa means 7, then o for oct, oct means 8, octopus, 8 legs, then e for Enia. Enia is 9. So first letter is E. Therefore, suppose it is given as 104. So how can you call it? Uni, nil. What is 4? Quad. So quadrinium. Uni, nil, quadrinium. So that will be the temporary name of the element having atomic number 104. Okay, this is out of scope for 9th standard. Just for the sake of completion, I have mentioned it here. You need not learn it here. You, when you go to 10th standard or 11th standard, you can learn in detail about them. So now let us take in alphabetical order. So how these elements were symboled? Aluminium. So what is the first two letter? Al. Therefore, the symbol of aluminium is Al. Why A is not taken? As I told you before, in English language, A is a one letter word. And also an article, very frequently used letter or word in English, A. Therefore, A symbol is not given to any element here. And second one, gold, Latin name is aurum. And what is the first two letter? AU. Therefore, the symbol for gold is AU. Then argon, what is the first two letter? AR. So the symbol of argon is AR. Next is arsenic. See, if you take the first two letter, AR is already given to argon, am I right? Therefore, R cannot be. Therefore, what is the first consonant after R? S. Therefore, it is AS. A and S. Therefore, what is the symbol for arsenic? AS. So, the next element is astatine. See, again, the first two letters, no? AS. S is also already given. Therefore, what is the next consonant? T. Therefore, the symbol for astatine is AT. A and then it is T. Therefore, AT. Okay, the next element is silver. What is the Latin name for silver? Argentum. So, if you take the first two letter, AR is given to argon. So, what is the next consonant? G. Am I right? Therefore, symbol for silver is A and the next letter is G. Okay, always the first letter should be uppercase and the second letter should be lowercase. That's very, very important. So, uppercase means capital letter, lowercase means small letter. So, next element is actinium. So, what is the first two letter? The first two letters are A and C. Therefore, the symbol of actinium is AC. Then, the next element is americium. So, what is the first two letter? AM. AM is not given to any other element. Therefore, we can take the first two letter AM here. So, that is a symbol of americium. Is it clear? So, there were 8 elements in starting in letter A, alphabet A. So, they were all given 2 letter symbols. A is not given. Single letter symbol is not given. Is it clear? Okay, shall we move on to elements name starting with B. So, boron. So, what is the first letter of boron? B. Therefore, symbol for boron is B. Then, barium. So, B is already given to boron. Therefore, we have to take the next letter. So, BA. So, BA is a symbol of barium. So, now you can understand why one letter for one element, why two letters for some other elements. Is it clear? Okay, the first letter should be caps. And the second letter should be small. That is, first letter should be uppercase, second letter should be lowercase. So, third one is beryllium. So, BE. The first two letters are B and E. Therefore, the symbol of beryllium is BE. What is the next element? Bromine. So, what is the first letter? B. Second letter is R, which is not given to any of them before. Therefore, the symbol of bromine is BR, the first two letters. Okay, what's the next one? Borium. What is the first two letter? BH. Okay, this is also not given to anything before. Therefore, the symbol of borium is BH. Bismuth, BI. First two letters are BI. Therefore, what is the symbol of barium? BI. Is it clear? I hope it's very clear now how the symbols were assigned to different elements. Then berkelium. So BE is already given. Am I right? BE is already given to beryllium. So next consonant is R. So that is also already given to what? Bromine. Therefore, what is the next consonant? K. So BK. Therefore, that is the symbol for berkelium. B and then K. B and K is berkelium. Is it clear? It is very, very interesting to learn by this way. So instead of simply memorizing the element's name and symbol without knowing any reason, what is the logical idea behind it? So that is why learning becomes boring. So try to understand what is the rule and what is the logical reason behind it, and that will be very interesting to learn, because we need not memorize, just we can find out on our own. Okay, so next let's move on to C. Carbon, I go very quickly now because you understood. So what is the first letter? C. Therefore symbol is C. Then calcium, first two letters Ca, so Ca is a symbol for calcium. Then chlorine, already we had seen chlorine and chromium, both will be having CH. Therefore the next consonant should be taken. Therefore C and L is taken. Therefore chlorine Cl. Then cobalt, the first two letters CO. So here we have to be very careful. First letter C should be uppercase. Second letter O should be lowercase, CO. Suppose you write both in uppercase CO, that becomes carbon monoxide gas, which is a compound. Therefore, we need to be very careful when we write cobalt. C caps and O small. Okay. Then 5, chromium. See, chlorine and chromium. Second letter is H. Therefore, here the symbol is C and R. First letter is C and second letter is R. Therefore, symbol is CR. So, next, cadmium. So, A is given already, am I right, for calcium. Therefore, CD. That should be the symbol for cadmium. C. And then the next consonant is D. Therefore, CD. Next is cerium. So, CE. First two letters, which is not given to any of the metals already, or any of the elements already. Therefore, CE for cerium. Then cesium. So CA is already given. CE is also already given. What is the next consonant? S. Therefore, C and S will be the symbol for cesium. What is the next one? Californium. So CA is already given. CL is also already given. I is a vowel. Therefore, that is omitted. Then what is that? What is the next consonant? F. Therefore, for californium, CF. CF will be the symbol for californium. Okay, next one. Curium. Okay, what is Cu? Already we know that is for copper. We have learned so many times. Okay, Cu, not possible. Cr is also not possible. And then I and U, not possible. I is a vowel, U is also a vowel, but that is also given to copper already. Then M only is there. So the first letter and last letter. So therefore the symbol is CM for curium. Okay, 11. Copernicium. So here the symbol is C and N. C and N. Okay, the last one, copper. So cuprum, Latin name is cuprum, and that is why it is taken as Cu. First two letters Cu. Is it clear? So C has got 12 elements and how the symbols were assigned. So here for C, single letter element is there, carbon. For B also boron is given. Only A is not given. I gave you the reason already. Okay, you should know the reason also. Okay, so shall we move on to D? So there are three elements starting with letter D. Dysprosium, the first two letters are DY, therefore the symbol is DY. Second one is Dubnium, therefore the symbol is D and B. So U is omitted, maybe it is a vowel, they might have omitted here, because immediately following that there is a consonant DB, therefore that must be easier to remember, therefore DB for Dubnium. And third one, Darmstadtium, so here the symbol is D and S, D and S, they have taken the first letter of the two syllables, Darmstadtium, okay, D and S. Okay, again there are three elements starting with letter E. Europium, so what is the first two letter? EU. The second element is Erbium, what is the first two letters? ER. What is the third element? Einsteinium, so what is the symbol for Einsteinium? E and S, Einsteinium, ES. So Einsteinium, atomic number 99. Okay, so these are the three elements. So try to understand how these symbols were designed or assigned, or why each and every element is given that particular symbol. If you learn with reasons, that will stick very well in our mind for a longer period. So shall we move on to the next one? Then F, fluorine, so what is the first letter? F, therefore symbol is F, it is a single letter symbol. Then iron, what is the Latin name? Ferrum, therefore the first two letters are Fe, therefore symbol of iron is Fe. And then francium, the first two letters Fr, therefore symbol for francium is Fr. Then now we have taken G, so gallium, so what is the first two letter of gallium? Ga. And then gadolinium, what is the first two letter? Ga. So Ga is already taken for gallium, so what is the next consonant? D, therefore Gd is a symbol for gadolinium. Okay, now germanium, so Ge can be given because E is not given to any other element before, therefore Ge, the first two letters, so that will be the symbol for germanium. Everything is very clear, no, why this is assigned. Okay, now let's move on to the next one. So next we see elements starting with the letter H. Hydrogen, what is the first letter? H, therefore the symbol is H. Second, helium, so H is already given to hydrogen, therefore you take the first two letters HE, so helium. And mercury, what is its Latin name? Hydrar gyrum, hydrar gyrum, first letter of hydrar is H, gyrum first letter is G, therefore HG is taken as symbol here, H and G is taken as its symbol, HG. Okay, now let us move on to the next alphabet. Iodine, what is the first letter? I, therefore symbol of iodine is I. Indium, so I is already given to iodine, therefore you take the first two letters IN, so you can easily remember indium as India. Okay, so IN. And third one, iridium, again I is given but second letter is R, which is not given already, therefore for iridium we can take IR. Okay, so these are the three elements having I as the first letter. Now there is no element starting with letter J, so there are two letters which is not coming in element symbol, one is J, the other one is Q. These two letters, so far it had never come in the symbol of any element. Okay, so potassium, kalium, so what is the first letter of kalium? K, therefore the symbol of potassium is K. And krypton, what is the first two letter? K is already given to potassium, so second letter is R, therefore KR, that should be the symbol of krypton. Okay, so next let's move on to the next alphabet. So next let us see elements starting with letter L and M. Lanthanum, what is the first two letters? LA. Therefore LA is a symbol for lanthanum. Lithium, first two letters LI, that is a symbol for lithium. Then lutetium, what are the first two letters? LU, therefore symbol for lutetium is LU. So these are the three elements starting with letter L. Then M, already we had seen manganese and magnesium, isn't it? Manganese, M and N, because A will be same for magnesium and manganese. Therefore manganese symbol is MN. Then magnesium, first letter will be M, then A is common, we have omitted. Then next consonant is G, therefore MG, M and G. Okay, what's the third one? Molybdenum. So first letter is M, second letter is O. So no other element is having a second letter O. Therefore molybdenum symbol is MO. So next element starting with N. Nitrogen, what is the first letter? N, therefore symbol is N. So next, sodium, what is its Latin name? Natrium. So what are the first two letters? Na. So this one we already learnt in the last video, Na. Then neon, what are the first two letters? Ne. So next, nickel, what are the first two letters? Ni. That's it for elements starting with N. Next let's move on to O. Oxygen, what is the first letter? O, therefore symbol is O. Next is osmium. So first O is given already to oxygen. You take the second letter, S. Therefore symbol for osmium is OS. Okay, next let us see elements starting with letter P. Phosphorus, first letter is P, therefore symbol of phosphorus is P. Second element is lead, its Latin name is plumbum. So the first letter of the first syllable plum is P, and the first letter of the second syllable bum is B, therefore the symbol of lead is PB. And palladium, what are the first two letters of palladium? PA, therefore that will be the symbol for palladium. And polonium, the first two letters of polonium is PO. So which is not given to any other element already. Therefore PO is a symbol of polonium. Next one is platinum. Okay, the first letter is P and the second letter is L, but that is not given because one more element is also having the letter L, and next is A, is vowel, therefore it is not taken. What I told you, the first consonant should be taken, therefore next consonant after L is T only, therefore the symbol of platinum is PT. So the first letter is P, and the first consonant after the second letter, no, that is T, therefore PT. And third one, plutonium. See, here also PL is coming. That is why the PL symbol is not given to both these elements. So plutonium, so what should be the symbol? So P, okay, the first letter is P, okay, that's fine. Then L is not given, then U is vowel, T is already given, then O is also already given, am I right? Therefore what we need to take for plutonium, U only we have to take, because so many things are already given, and therefore we can easily take U for plutonium, P and U for plutonium. Okay, next let us see elements starting with R, because there is no element is starting with Q. So the first element in alphabet R is radium. So what are the first two letters of radium? RA. The next one, ruthenium, what are the first two letters? RU, therefore symbol of ruthenium is RU. Then radon, RA is already given, am I right? Here the first letter and last letter is given, R and then N, radon. Okay, so next is rhodium. RH is not given before, therefore RH will be the symbol for rhodium. and then rubidium, Ru is already given, am I right? For ruthenium, Ru is given. Therefore, for rubidium, the next consonant B is given. Therefore, Rb. Rb is a symbol of rubidium. So, next is element starting with letter S. Sulfur, first letter S, therefore symbol S. Scandium, first two letters are Sc, therefore symbol is Sc. Next, silicon, the first two letters are Si, therefore Si is a symbol of silicon. Next is tin, Latin name is tanum, which we had seen already in the previous video. The first letter S and then N, one of the two N's. So Sn is a symbol of tin. Next, selenium, the first two letters are Se, therefore the symbol of selenium is Se. Next, antimony, the Latin name is tibium. So here the symbol is given S and B, stibium. Okay, S and B, stibium. Okay. Next, letter starting in T, thorium. So what are the first two letters of thorium? TH. And then titanium, the two letters are, the first two letters are T and I. Therefore, titanium is TI. And then uranium, first letter U. Then vanadium, first letter V. So there is only one element in all these alphabets. Then tungsten, it is derived from the German name Wolfram. So what is it? W. And then for X, xenon. Number the name starting with alphabet X is xenon. So what is the symbol? The first letter X and second letter E. XE is a symbol of xenon. Then finally Y and Z. So yttrium, the first letter is Y, therefore Y is a symbol of yttrium. And another one is ytterbium. Okay, so what are the two letters for ytterbium? Y cannot be given because Y is given to yttrium. Ytterbium. Okay, ytter is the first letter of the first syllable and bium, B is the first letter of the second syllable, therefore YB. And similarly, Z also is having two elements starting with letter Z. Zinc, what is that? ZN. I is not taken. Y you will understand after seeing the next one. ZN. Zirconium, this is also starting with Z and second letter is I. Therefore, I is omitted for both the names. So, Z and after I, the first consonant is N for zinc. And here in zirconium, after I, after the second letter I, the first consonant is R. Therefore, zirconium is Z and R. Therefore, symbol of zirconium is ZR. Is it clear? So, we have covered almost most of the elements, very important elements. If you are still interested, you can take your textbook and you can find all the 118 elements and you can try to find out the symbol on your own based on all these rules. It will be very, very interesting and it will stick very well in your mind for a long period. So now you are in 9th standard. You can remember even when you go to 12th standard, even after finishing your school or after finishing your university also. You can remember it for a longer period if you learn anything with logical ideas, reasons and rules and regulations. Simply don't memorize anything. Try to understand the logic behind it like this and it will stick very well in your mind. And what are the significance of a symbol? It is just not a symbol. It is not just a letter or two letters. And what are the other things it tells us when we represent any element by its symbol? So first of all, it gives the name of the element. And second thing, that represents one atom of that element. And third thing, it tells us the definite mass of the element, that is the atomic mass or atomic weight of that element in grams. These are the three datas a symbol signifies. Okay, for example, let us try to understand this with some examples. So let us take oxygen symbol O. So that O represents the element oxygen and it represents one atom of oxygen. It also represents its atomic mass 16 grams. That is, atomic mass of oxygen is 16 grams. So it represents all these three datas. Okay, one more example we see. So let us take calcium. So symbol Ca stands for calcium, and it represents one atom of calcium. The atomic mass of calcium is 40, therefore 40 grams of calcium. That represents atomic mass of calcium in grams. Hope students you understood everything what I explained in detail. Of course it is an hour video, it is too long, but still it is worth going through all these basic points and basic ideas to learn and remember. Okay, so in the next video we will be learning about valency of these elements, how to find out the valency of these elements. So that is very, very, very important topic. It is as important as the symbols of these elements. And using the symbols and valencies only, we can write the formula for any number of compounds on our own. Therefore, these two topics are really very, very, very important. So better you go through these videos at least 3 to 5 times so that you can understand the logical idea behind it, so that you can take this element symbols into your long-term memory effortlessly. Thank you very much, students, for watching this. Until we meet next time, bye bye.